All right, so looking at what we have so far, we have our music track down below, and I've zoomed in a bit on it, and you can see I have my three markers that I set up according to the sound patterns, right? The way that the music was coming in, I set the markers there using the M key. Now, I downloaded three short clips from Pexels, just some ocean clips, and I'm going to use these, and what I want to do now is set them so that they start right on the markers, right, to create that sort of effect. So let's just jump to this first marker. Now remember, if we hold down the shift key and type M, boom, it jumps us right to the marker. I'm there, okay? So I'll take this first clip and I'm just going to drag it, and I'm going to drag it over, and I'm going to drop it. Notice that when I get right on the marker, you see that little triangle pops up, shows me I'm right there. Let go. Now, it's actually there. Now, notice that this clip is longer than I need, right? I don't actually want it to be that long. I can always adjust it by putting my cursor on the edge here and pulling. I'll just make it a bit shorter than what we need. So there it goes. Now, let's just see what this looks like when I rewind it and play. Now it worked exactly the way I wanted it to work. You can see that it started right on the marker, right? Now, that essentially is how you do it. Now you could move from marker to marker, right? You can keep doing Shift M, jump to the next marker, put your next cut right there, then continue like that, going all the way through your all your sound clips like that. Now, one other useful trick is sometimes your marker might be a little bit off, right? When you were hitting the M key, you may have just missed it a little bit. One thing I found super helpful is to click on my clip if I need to, if I need to adjust it. What you can do is hold down the Command key and then use the left arrow or right arrow and watch what happens. It's called nudging, and it just makes your clip move one frame over in that direction. Sometimes you might need to move it a couple frames to get it to show up right there, right on the edge of your marker. So that is how you do it. This is super useful. You can use this a lot of times. You might have a song going where all of a sudden the song is going along, and then there's a drum that just appears in the middle of the song, and you want your clip to start right on the beginning of that drum beat, and boom, now you know how you can set it up that way using markers, which are super helpful and fun.